So last but not least, let us look at the intermediate format. Again, I will not go really into details. I rather want to give you an impression of this, because this you will see at there we really had to dig deep into details to look at the formats and the numbers and all that. This is something when you're really interested in, well, this is nicely documented, and also you can just work your way through the slides. But believe me, you don't want to listen to me going through this in detail. Anyway, let me now give you an overview. Okay, so as I said, S-Models was the very first ASP solver, and they actually coined, of course, at the beginning the language formats and in particular the primitives. As I mentioned when we went through the first section, we looked at, well, actually in the introduction part, even normal rules, and now in the first section of this part, choice rules, cardinality rules, weight rules, and these guys are the primitives in the S-Models format. So more or less the grounder spits out a program that has these four types of rules. And in addition, there are minimized directives which are implemented as minimized statements. So a particular feature of this format was it was block oriented. So more or less you parse your program, you ground, and you more or less had to keep this in memory because you wanted to spit it out in blocks, first the rules, then the symbols, and then perhaps some other instructions, right? And when we actually came up with the ASP format, there were different motivations. Also, we wanted to have theory constraints, so more or less new language concepts that you can add on the fly. But there we wanted a line-based format. And I'll show this with ASP in a sec. Okay, just to tell you that this is a basic distinction, because with S-Models, you had to keep things in memory until you could spit out the blocks at the end. Good, so here's the description of the format. Again, I will not go in details. Also, I apologize for the bad references, but I was just LaTeXing this part, and this is in the introductory part, and the normal rules are in the introductory part, and disjunctive rules in the extension part, and hence I don't get the cross references. But this will be in the overall slide stack. And now I zip it again. But what you see here is really, so we had this rule, this normal rule, A0 was the head. Then we had the these are actually the negative elements, right? So AM plus 1 bis AN, the negative body literals, and this is the positive body. And so they are all encoded inside, and here you have the numbers, right? So we have n elements in the body, and n minus m, which are then these guys here, right? N negative elements, so more or less then it knows that the next n minus m are negative ones, and here it will then find the positive ones. So more or less this is the idea of the format. And these are blanks, that's part of the format, and then all these atoms, because keep in mind here only the atoms of the body of the positive and the negative body are represented, are mapped onto numbers. So and literals are then integers where you have a negative number designates a negative literal, and a positive number a positive literal. And this is more or less what happens here. So in the solver, all the literals are represented by integers. Okay? So this is more or less how this format works. Just to give you an example without going in detail, just keep in mind that normal rules start with the 1, choice rules with the 3. So if we do this here, this is a very simple program with a choice rule and 2 normal rules. And this is what comes out. Here you have a choice rule. This represents this guy. And here we have the 2 normal rules. Here we have the symbol table, right? That says, A is actually, the atom A is represented by 2, the atom C by 3, and the atom B by 4. And then there are some compute statements which lead us actually in too much detail. So this is more or less the S-Models format. And again, historically, it defined the primitive language constructs that we've seen at the beginning, where semantics was given also actually by Ilkay Nemela and his group by translations back into normal rules. So now what we are using is the so-called ASPIF format. And you see the ASPIF format is much richer. It has rule statements. And actually, these rule statements capture everything that you have seen except for the minimized statement. So more or less, the rule statement and the minimized statements capture what I've been discussing, and otherwise there are projection statement. You've seen the directive project show, well, things that emerge from the show statements. Then other externals and assumptions is again for the solver. heuristic statements, you've seen the heuristic directive, the edge statement, you've seen that as well. And then there are theory terms and atoms. This is if you want to extend the grammar, or actually if you want to extend the language, you can furnish a grammar that describes new language constructs. For instance, if you want to represent linear equations or differential equations, or I just talked about the very complex stuff, but even other things, right? You can define your own language and the arguments. And as I was saying, this is process, and the format is designed in a way that it's a line-oriented format. So things are spit out. So each rule is spit out once it's grounded, and it doesn't sit in memory. This is one of the computational features of this format. Let us look again at the same example, but not really go into much detail. And what we only do is we look at this and only at how rule statements actually are encoded. So rule statements start with a one, and then a blank, and then there is the encoding of the head and the encoding of the body. So let's first look at the head. So more or less, what is between these two blanks here? So more or less, the idea is that a head is either a disjunction or a choice, right? And this is determined by the H. So this more or less, this here is the string that you put here for the big H. So this is determined by 0 or 1 here. And then again, you have the number of head literals, and each AI is then a positive literal here, right? So this is the head. And keep in mind that this covers more or less everything, right? Heads are disjunctions or choices. And if you have a normal rule, this actually means there is a disjunction with a single element. You cannot map normal rules on choice rules, because this would mean that you add the head or not, right? So in a disjunction with one element, this amounts to a single atom. And this is actually then the guy that represents the head of a normal rule. Okay, so just to get this special case done, that we also cover normal rules as a special case of rules with a disjunctive head. Okay, then the body works a little bit in the same way, and let me not go through this in detail. Again, we have two types. We have either normal bodies, where we just have literals, or we have weight bodies. Again, there is some normalization happening. It's a little bit like with the S-models form, that you have weight rules or rules with a normal body, and things are then normalized towards these syntactic structures. And this actually captures all types of rules of that we have discussed so far. This is actually what happens in the intermediate format. And again, I'm on purpose hand-waving a little bit, because you don't want to go with me through, or listen to me when I go through the details, right? Because then I have to zip it all the time. Okay, now I'll zip it for real. Okay, let's look at the example without going in details. So this is our example, and this is now the corresponding ASPIF format. Here there is actually a verb. This says it's the type of this is now ASP, because actually class, for instance, can also be used for SAT solving or for PB solving or even some nuances of that. Then you have here more or less the rules. This is the one here. And here actually you see there's a negative body literal, and this is represented here by the minus one. And here the 4 gives the output statements. This is actually where the symbol table maps actually symbols to numbers. And here we terminate actually with a 0 in the end. So more or less, yet another format which the solver loves, but we as humans, well, it's not our piece of cake. Okay, anyway, so this was almost our part on the language. Now, the only thing that remains is to wrap up and to name a couple of things to remember.